This interactive simulation looks at diffusion in solids and choice of three systems for diffusion. We can change the diffusing species mole percent at the surface, so that's this value right here. We can change the temperature, and that's going to increase the rate of diffusion. And then we can change the time, so we can basically move this slider along and look at how a species will diffuse and how its concentration will change as a function of time. So let's look at the full snapshot here. We're plotting mole percent versus distance, and the color coding corresponds to this is copper and aluminum, this is carbon in iron, and then this is copper and nickel, which diffuses much slower. So now we look at the interactive simulation and see what happens as we change these parameters using the sliders. So here in the interactive simulation, I've selected to just initially look at copper and aluminum. So notice the blue indicating the blue line. And for a fixed surface concentration, 1.1%, at this temperature, which note is pretty high temperature, diffusion in solids can be slow. Then as the time proceeds, you can see how the concentration profile changes and material diffuses further, in this case copper, diffuses further into aluminum. If I select copper into nickel, notice that it's really quite slow and the green line here shows almost no diffusion. In contrast, if I select carbon into iron, it's diffused almost as much as the copper and aluminum. If I raise the temperature, we see there is a difference, and at the very highest temperatures, we see some diffusion of copper into nickel. So we can also change the surface concentration. And notice the behavior of the curves out at longer times when we change the surface concentrations. So hopefully it gives you a little better idea of this behavior of diffusion. In this case in solids, which takes place typically at relatively high temperatures.